What's up, team? It is your biggest fan, The Real Casadero here, and in this session, we're talking about why you should just stop trying to learn to code. This is why learning to code is so hard. This is what you should do instead. Now, I realize that the title's clickbaity. What I just said is clickbaity. It's all clickbaity, but if you stick around to the end, this is gonna make sense, and you're gonna have an aha moment, and your whole perspective on everything is gonna be changed. All right, team, so it's your biggest fan, The Real Casadero, and we're here and we're talking about why you should stop trying to learn to code. This is why learning to code is so hard. This is what you should do instead. So I set out to learn to code a long time ago, and I've been learning for a long time, and I know all kinds of stuff. I don't know what it is that I don't know. I know I don't know everything. There's still a bunch of stuff to learn. I know that the more you learn, the more you need to learn. It's a never-ending cycle. The point is when I set out to build code, and like most people, I would assume, is because they wanted to build something or they had some sort of passion for something. They were obsessed with this thing. Maybe it's obsessed with computers. Maybe it's obsessed with making computers do stuff. Maybe it's obsessed with finding a job. Maybe it's obsessed with whatever. It doesn't really matter. The deal is that when it comes to learning to code, code is a tool. It is just a thing that we use in order to tell computers to do stuff. And we want to tell computers to do stuff because there is something else that needs to be done. Somebody needs to be entertained. Somebody needs to pay a bill. Somebody needs to get paid. Somebody needs to clock in at work. Somebody needs to clock out. Somebody needs to track stuff on a calendar. Somebody needs to do stuff in a spreadsheet, right? It's infinite. The number of problems that can be solved with code are infinite. There's tons of them. But there's not a lot of people who want to provide solutions. In society, we've got people who are, everybody sees a problem. Everybody knows what a problem looks like. And then you got a smaller group of people. They're like, hey, I see this problem. I want to solve this problem. And they set out to solve the problem. And they spend their entire lives trying to solve this problem. And then you have an even smaller group of people who are like, you know, I see all the problems. I think I can fix this problem. I'm gonna provide a solution for that. And then you have some people who become completely obsessed with providing that solution. And those are typically the ones that have this upward trajectory, like super quick. Like they've come up with something that just everybody wants, and that's what happens. The deal is that we don't want to be the people on this side who all we see is problems. But it's hard to get to the side where we're like super obsessed with something unless it's meaningful to us. And I mean like meaningful in the sense that it is going to support the lives we want to live, the things we want to do, the relationships we want to have, all these different things. All these different things play a factor, but a lot of people don't think about those things. I didn't think about those things. It's just the way it is, right? You don't know what you don't know until you know it, until you learn it. But the deal is learning to code is hard because of the way we're learning to code. And I remember when my first computer science class, I went into the class, there was no computers there, and I was like, dude, this is crazy. People are out here building all kinds of software on the internet, and I'm in this class, I got no computers. I want to learn to build stuff right away. And we started learning a language called Fortran. And at the time, I was like, dude, I couldn't even use Fortran on my home computer. Like, I would have to be at the school, in the basement, on the mainframe, writing my code, and then it would print out on this piece of paper, and I would pull my hair out trying to figure out the bugs, and eventually it would work, and then it would be 2 a.m, and then I would go home, wake up at 6, go to work, and I would try to do this over and over again, like 2 to 3 times a week. It was a complete nightmare. I didn't make it through that journey, team. The deal is, though, is that what they were trying to teach was the fundamentals, understanding of how to communicate with the computer. And once you understand that, then you can apply that with any language, with any, just about any technology that's available to us today. The problem is that me, I didn't understand, and the teacher, he didn't convey it. Like, it was never explained to us. Maybe it was. Maybe I just missed it. Maybe I was too young. Maybe I wasn't paying attention. Maybe I was, like, still asking the question, where are all the god computers in here? This doesn't make any, where's the computers? I don't see the computer. This computer science class got no computers. In building my own application, and in building commercial websites and all these other things, like, it dawned on me. Like, here, just a few days ago, it just dawned on me, like, every problem has these small tiny elements, and our goal is to solve the problem. And that most people see the problem, but every problem has these little pieces. When we write code, each piece of code is designed to solve a small part of this larger problem. So we got somebody who needs to log on. Every piece of code we write solves a little problem. So first we have to figure out who this person is. There's some code for that. Then we have to figure out if the username and password match what's in the database, or if it even exists in the database at all. So the next piece of code is, hey, grab this username and password and see if they exist in the database. If not, then we need to do something else. And that's gonna be send them to another page where they can create an account. But if it does exist, does the username and password match what we have in the database? And if it does, then we can authenticate them. But after this next step has been met, maybe a cap, whatever, it doesn't matter. But that's, the problem is we, when we start learning, we get into these, we go to school, we take tutorials, we go to boot camps, we do all these things. They show us how to build stuff. We learn how to build all kinds of stuff. But a lot of the times, because we don't have understanding of what it is we're trying to accomplish and all the steps in what we're trying to accomplish, it all gets sort of glossed over. We remember the syntax on how to do a bunch of different things, but we don't know why we use that syntax in the first place. But we keep moving along because we're thinking, if we do this enough times, then it'll make sense and we'll be able to build something. And that's the truth. Like, it is. Like, it, and I'll talk about this in a different video. There's a way to use tutorials to like really accelerate your learning curve. But for people who are just starting out, the tutorial, it'll make you feel good because you built some stuff. But when you finish, typically you don't know where to go after that. And that's the problem. And the job hunt sucks us into it as well, because we get these, we go out, apply for these jobs, and they're like, we need a React developer. So we go learn React. We already learned HTML, CSS, JavaScript, and probably a couple other languages. And I was like, we got to go learn React. What's React? Is that another language? So we go learn React. And then they're like, well, we need somebody who has experience with Gulp. Dude, like, I just learned React. What's Gulp? And now you go out and you learn Gulp. While you're learning Gulp, you learn about this other thing. And now you learn it. And then you're learning all these different things. You're not building anything. You're not building anything for yourself. You're not building anything for an employer. You're just trying to get a job. And you're trying to learn all this other stuff. And in the end, you still feel like an imposter because you're confused, because you don't know the fundamental. You don't know that every problem has a bunch of tiny problems that all come together to make the big problem. And if you can figure out how to solve one little problem at a time, you can build just about anything you want to build, even your very own version of React. Somebody built React, and they built React because they were doing all these different things. Maybe there were some repetitive tasks, maybe there was some issues with state transfer or whoever, who knows what, like some hardcore heavy computer science stuff, which is going to come up when you're dealing with hundreds of thousands of millions, billions of users on a daily basis. A framework may be necessary at some point, especially a framework is necessary, especially if you going to employ other people. So you gotta tell people to learn the framework because it makes it easier. That's why these frameworks are open source, because they create a ready pool of people who know how to work this thing. And the people who really master it are gonna rise to the top and they'll get those jobs. But for people who are just starting out, one of the most powerful things you can do is say, this is a problem that I see and I want to build some software to solve this problem. And it can be big, it can be small. I recommend you start with something small because it's gonna make it easier. Little wins lead to big wins. If you start with something small and you work your way through it, you muddle your way through it, you build it, you understand way more than somebody who sat in a ton of classes and have written a bunch of code copied line for line from somebody else. You will know, because you will know how to build. You will know what to do. You will know, right? For me to select this list of items, I gotta do a document.query selector all, grab the list of items, but once I get it, I need to go over this list and transfer it into some sort of an array. But maybe there's another way to do that. But you understand this concept. Like, there's people out there who are working jobs who don't understand that. And that's fine. That's nothing. It's whatever, right? I've been in both places. I've been in places where I was super smart. I knew everything that was going on. They paid me a lot of money. I've been in places where I didn't know anything. Nothing. How I got the job, I don't even know. They were still paying me a lot of money. I was learning. It is whatever. But the point is, right, is that instead of trying to learn the code, start thinking in terms of solutions. And when we think in terms of solutions, we are forced to break down the problem. We're going to get out of here after this. Elon Musk is like, I want to go to Mars. Huge problem. He wants to provide a solution for it. Because nobody's ever gone to Mars before. Like, not a human being, at least, as far as we know. What's the first step in me getting to Mars? I need rockets. And so Elon literally went to Russia shopping for rockets with his own money that he made at PayPal. He's out shopping for rockets, not worried about the next step. In order to get to space, I need rockets. And maybe I don't even need rockets. I need some sort of propulsion system that'll get me off the planet Earth into outer space and then propel me through outer space towards Mars. And the only thing we know that's capable of doing that right now that we have that's available that won't cost unfathomable amounts of money is rockets. So he went looking for rockets. Then he got the rocket and it's like, okay, how do I take off with the rocket? Figures out how to take off. And then he's like, okay, if I take off with a rocket, I need to be able to reuse use these rockets because rockets are really expensive. So now I'm gonna figure out how to land the rocket. And this solves two problems, because if I can land the rocket here, I can probably land the rocket there. You guys see what I'm getting at? You don't have to be a rocket scientist to get to Mars. You just have to understand that rockets have been used, and now you gotta find a rocket. So you wanna write something to a database. How do I do that? There's a language for it. Learn the language, write it to the database. What's the next step in the process? All right, team, I'm your man, the real Casadero, your biggest fan. If that made sense to you, leave a comment below. If it didn't make sense to you, leave a comment below anyway. But at any rate, continue to learn to code, but with a purpose, because this purpose is gonna drive you towards a better understanding of what it is you're trying to learn, team. That is it for now. I will see you in the next session.